to the class. Let us discuss about new chapter of geography, that is about the transport. The transport system of Karnataka. What is the importance of transport and how the transport developed in Karnataka? And what is the role of transport in the development of economy? The economy of state Karnataka as well as the country India. So here we are going to discuss about the importance of transport, uses of transport and the development of transport and different modes of transport or the different types of transport. Transport refers to, then what do you mean by transport? The system of carrying persons and goods from one place to another. It is a system of carrying goods or the persons from one place to another place. It's called as a transport. It is a lifeline in the progress of agricultural sector, industrial sector and commercial sector or commercial activities. So it is considered as a lifeline. Why it is considered as a lifeline to agricultural activities or industrial activities or the commercial activities? Because without transport, all the works related to all these three sectors is very difficult. That's why one thing it is difficult, on the other side, development is not possible. That's why the role of transport is very, very important and it is considered as the lifeline to the progress of agriculture, industry and commerce. Karnataka is a land with varied natural resources. Like India, even Karnataka is also blessed with the different varieties of natural resources. Resources like minerals, commercial crops, forest products and sources of energy. All these are abundantly that is blessed by Karnataka. This is the natural resources. You know that what is the role of natural resources in the development of the country. Why the country should always develop? Why? The reason is in order to improve the standard of living of the people, country should be developed. That's why here the use of these resources are very, very important. If the country is blessed with natural resources but it is not utilized in a proper way, then it is not considered as a development. Here, whatever natural resources are, if it is used for the purpose of production, purpose of development, then only it is useful. So, for the effective use of natural resources, for the effective supply of natural resources from one place to another place, here transport plays very, very important role. In order to achieve economic development through proper use of these resources, an efficient transport system is essential. In order to use all these natural resources for the purpose of the development of the country, here transport is important. So whatever extracted minerals from the earth, for the supply of that minerals from one place to another, we need the support of transport. In the absence of transport system, just imagine how it could be supplied from one place to another place. That's why the role of transport is important for the development of the country. Different means of transport facilities are necessary to transport food grains and other agricultural produce. The facility of transport is important. Why? Mainly because to supply the goods, that is food grains as well as other agricultural produce from that production center to the market. That is important. Next, minerals from the mines. Whatever minerals extracted from the mining center, then supplying from that mines to the production center or to the not production center, factories or to the industries. Here, transport facility is very, very important. Next, manufactured goods from the factories. After finished goods, after the production of the manufacturing goods or finished goods, next marketing, that is shifting to market. For that also, here transport facility is very, very important. Then minerals from mines, manufactured goods from the factories, people from one place to another and for various other purposes. So remember, what are the importance of transport or what are the uses of transport or what are the facilities provided by the transport? If the question asked, answer is this, that is first one, it provides facilities that is such as transport, food grains and other agricultural produce to the market, mineral from mines, that is transporting minerals from mines, manufactured goods from their factories, people from one place to another place. These are all the uses or the importance of a transport. Karnataka has well developed road, rail, water and air transport facilities. The means of trade, means of transport or the what are the modes of transport or the what are the types of transport in Karnataka. That is, first one is road transport, second one is rail transport, next water, waste or the water transport, and one more is the airways. So these are important modes or the means of transport in Karnataka. Let us discuss about these modes of transport one by one. So first one is road transport. What is the importance of road transport in Karnataka? A large number of people live in rural areas in Karnataka. So road transport occupies a very important role in linking the villages and the towns. You know that India is considered as a land of villages. India is agricultural land and it is a land of villages. And we are speaking about the transport system of Karnataka in 9th standard, only about Karnataka. So even Karnataka, in Karnataka also rural areas are more. Here people live in rural areas in Karnataka. So road transport, why road transport is very, very important in Karnataka? Mainly the main reason is to link the people of rural areas with the people of towns or the people of cities. That was the main reason, to link the people with the village with the towns. That was the main reason. Next, roads can be constructed easily. One more thing is, compared to other mode of transport, other means of transport, road transport is cheap compared to other modes. So road can be constructed easily at low cost. People and goods can be transported to every corner of the state. Remember, what are the importance of road transport? The first step or most importance is to link the people of village with the towns. Second one, roads can be constructed easily at low cost. Next, people and goods can be transferred from one place to another place. At the same time, they can be transported or they can carry or they can move from one corner to another corner of the state. Next, development of roads determines the progress of the state's agriculture, industry, mining and commerce. The role of all these three are very, very important in the development of the state and development of the country. That's why it provides opportunity for what? For the development of agriculture, development of industry, development of mining and commerce. Our role of all these are important in the development of the country as well as economy. Development of road transport. How the development of road transport taken place in Karnataka? Road transport has been in use from ancient times in Karnataka. It is not a recent development. It's developed from ancient times, ancient period. You know that whenever learnt about some of the dynasties, during that period itself the trade was developed. That is, internal trade and the external trade, international trade was developed during that period. So without the transport facility, the development of international trade was impossible. So it shows that the trade, road transport was already developed in the ancient period. Kings and emperors constructed roads for the use of their soldiers and for administrative purposes. The main purpose for the construction of roads by the king and the emperor of different dynasties, one thing that is for the importance that is given to the soldiers, to roads should be used by the soldiers and also for the administrative purpose. That is the second important reason for the construction of road during ancient period. There were travel shelters. They even constructed some of the travel shelters. A place to rest and water to drink were available. That place is called as the travel shelter. Shelters like resting shelters, orchards and chaudhries. These places are called as the resting places, where the shelter is provided to the travelers as well as even the water supply, drinking water supply also provided to these people in that particular areas. So in order to establish these centers, that shelters and shelters for the travelers, because during that period that was the people took the long journey. That's why in some corners, in some places, they established the shelters, that is resting shelters. And each resting shelters were connected with the roads. That is the main purpose is for the use of soldiers as well as for the administrative purpose during the period of kings. Roads to connect the coastal regions to the island areas, that is inland areas, had been constructed. All the inland areas are connected with the, were connected with the coastal region. Each and every corners of the state connected with the roads. That's why road transport was very important. In this way, the road transport was developed. Roads were not much developed in the pre-independence days in Karnataka. Even though it was developed or it was introduced or it was set up in the ancient time, but it was not developed in a large extent before independence, pre-independent period in Karnataka. There were roads linking Bengaluru and the district centers in the old Mysore province, but they were not well organized. Mainly these roads were developed, especially in Karnataka, mainly in Bengaluru as well as in Mysore state. Not in all the places it was well organized. Only the important city centers of India was developed with the road transport, like Bengaluru and old Mysore province. After independence, when the Vishala Mysore state was formed, that is in the year 1956, final unification was took place and Karnataka Vishala Mysore state was came into formation or came into existence in the year 1956. Afterwards, in the year in 1961, totally 43,182 kilometers of roads were laid under the department called KSRTC. So, for the first time, Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation was established in the year 1961. That KSRTC set up in the year 1961 after the unification of Karnataka. So, here under this plan, that is under the, that project, here they took the importance of constructing total 43,182 kilometers of roads were formed or laid in the Karnataka. For the first time, importance had given for the establishment of a road. That is after the independence and after the unification of Karnataka. At present, the total length of the road is 2,231,062 kilometers. That is the present length of the road that was constructed in Karnataka, of which 35.70% are metalled roads, and whereas 64.30% are unmetalled roads. Because already we discussed that here Karnataka is a land of villages. In land villages, almost roads are unmetalled. It is a kaccha road. There has been an improvement in the quality of roads constructed through. Even though it is unmetalled, but the quality was maintained for the during the construction of these roads. Then what are the types of roads? Roads in Karnataka have been classified into four kinds. They are, first one, national highways. Second one, state highways. Third one, district roads. And fourth one, village roads. So remember, what are the kinds of road transport? So modes of transport is different. Kinds of roads are different. So what are the kinds of roads? The first, national highways. Second one, state highways. Third one, district roads. And last one, village roads. Let us discuss about the kinds of roads one by one. First one, national highways. You might have heard about these national highways and they might have seen these national, well-developed national highways. Roads which link important cities, capitals of states and ports are called national highways. What is national highways? The road that which link important cities of the state, then capitals of the country and or the states and ports are called as a national highway. That is not restricted to particular state. It connecting one state with another state, one capital with another capital, one more that is city with another city, and even with the ports. That is called as a national highways. These are well planned wide roads and are 2-lane, 4-lane and 6-lane roads. It is totally consists of some roads are 2-lane and some are 4-lane and one more is a 6-lane, that is a quadrilateral roads that was established in the Karnataka as well as all over India. They are under the authority of central government. The construction of national highways was the authority given to the central government and are managed by the National Highways Authority of India, NHAI. National Highway Authority of India is looked after by all the whatever developments of the road under the control of central government. At present, there are 14 national highways in Karnataka. So, how many national highways are there in Karnataka? Total 14. Their total length is 4,491 kilometers. Remember, 14 national highways, it is under the control of NHAI, and NHAI completely under the control of central government. What do you mean by NHAI? National Highway Authority of India. About national highways, they have not been located equally among all the districts of the state. It's not equally distributed, not equally well developed in all the states, all the districts of the state. Uttara Kannada, Vijayapura, Belagavi, Shivamogga, Bengaluru Rural, Tumakuru, Dakshina Kannada and Bellari districts have more national highways. In Karnataka, these national highways are not distributed equally in all the districts. Especially it is more in the districts like Uttara Kannada, Vijayapura, Belagavi, Shivamogga, Bengaluru Rural, Tumakuru, Dakshina Kannada and Bellari district. Whereas Raichur and Kodagu districts have no national highways. Remember, the two districts of Karnataka, which are the two districts of Karnataka has no national highways. That is Raichur and Kodagu. Raichur and Kodagu districts have no national highways. National Highway NH4 and NH7 come under the National Highway Authorities. That is Golden Quadrilateral Highway Project as well as a Corridor Projects. Remember, important question, NH4 and NH7, National Highway 4 and National Highway 7 come under the jurisdiction of National Highway Authorities, Golden Quadrilateral Highway Projects as well as Corridor Projects. Remember, important in the next question. They have 6 lanes. These quadrilateral, golden quadrilateral national highways have total 6 lanes. The other main national highways passing through the state are NH206 and NH209, NH212, NH13, NH17, NH48. The longest in India is NH48. Remember? So, this is about the numbers as given for that particular roads, national highways mentioned along with the numbers, that is NH206, National Highway, NH means National Highway, 206, 209, 212, 13, 17 and 48. Second one, state highways. Roads which link the capital city of Bengaluru with the district headquarters, major towns and other highways are called as the state highways. So what are state highways? State highways are the road which link the capital city of Bengaluru. The Bengaluru is the capital city of Karnataka, which city is linked with the places of the district headquarters, major towns and other highways are called state highways. The construction and maintenance of these roads rests with the state government. The construction and maintenance of these roads under the control of state government National highways under the control of central governments. Remember, Karnataka has 20,905 kilometers of state highways. Belagavi has the longest state highway, whereas Bengaluru has the least. Remember, longest national highway, that state highway in Karnataka is a Belagavi, and the least one is a Bengaluru. Remember, important question for fill in the blanks. Next, third type of road is a district roads. Roads which link district headquarters with the taluk headquarters, major towns, villages, railways and major highways are called district roads. So what is the importance of district roads, sir? Or what are district roads? National highways, sir, nationwide, state, that is with the capital, with the districts, sir. And what about the districts? District headquarters, that links district headquarters with the taluk headquarters, major towns, villages, railways and major highways, called as a district roads. The construction, maintenance and supervision of these roads is under the control of Jilla Panchayats. Remember, first under central government, next under state government, third one district road, that is under the control of Jilla Parishad or Jilla Panchayat or Jilla Parishad. Karnataka state has a 47,836 kilometers of district highways. Tumakur district has maximum district highways and Raichur has the least. How Belagavi is the longest state highway. At the same time, Tumakur district has the longest or maximum district highways and Raichur is having least. So remember, fill in the blanks question. Next, last type of road is a village roads. Roads which link taluk headquarters with the village and district highways are called village roads. The construction and maintenance of these roads is under the taluk panchayat and the village panchayat. So this construction of village road is looked after by the village panchayat and the taluk panchayat. The quality of these roads is not good and in some parts it is very difficult to travel on these roads. So you can observe the roads, not only the village road, even the city's road, what is the condition now. So totally has gone, isn't it? So, but most of the roads in villages, that is a kacha road. And you know that because of the heavy rain, here what is the condition of these roads, that is village roads. That's why here mentioned the most of the roads condition is not at all good. The quality of these roads is not good. And some parts it is very difficult to travel on these roads. Karnataka has total 147,212 kilometers of village roads. That is a village roads total 147,212 kilometers of village road in Karnataka. In addition to the types of roads mentioned above, there are multi-purpose roads and roads under local administration. Whatever roads mentioned already, four types of roads, national highways, state highways, district roads and the village roads, along with that, the other roads are there. That roads are considered, they're constructed for the purpose of multi-purpose roads. That is considered as a multi-purpose roads. More than one or two purposes, that is called as a multi-purpose. So that is used for the multi-purpose and roads under, it is under the local administration. These multi-purpose roads are under the control of local administration. You know that nowadays in the present situation, everywhere roads, isn't it? In front of the house, in east of the house, east side of the house also road, west side of the house also road, everywhere the roads. So, it is nothing but multi-purpose roads. And these multi-purpose roads are constructed by the or looked after by the local administration. For instance, roads of public works, department, PWD, forest department, irrigation department and town municipality and city corporation. So, all these roads are under the control of public works department, forest department, irrigation department and town municipality. municipality and a city corporation. Such roads are called as a multi-purpose roads. So this much about the road transport.